Takes no lip of nobody and litter off the gutter. Puts it in the bag and never thinks to mutter. And he packs his lunch in the Sunday's bag. The children call him Bogey. He never lets on, but I know because he once told me. He let me know a secret about the money in his kitty. He's gonna buy a dinghy, gonna call her Dignity.
Paul from Racing's Inside Track and joined by apprentice Danny Sheehy. How are you, Danny?
Good, David, thank you.
You're having a great year.
Yeah.
10 winners so far, 9 in Ireland, 1 in England. Things are going well for you?
Yeah, going very well. Missed the start of the season, came back with a broken leg, but thanks to everyone giving me rides and my agent Rory Tierney, so all going well now.
And we're here on Adrian Keatley's this morning, and Adrian supports you in a big way and plenty of winners for Adrian.
Yeah, thanks to Adrian, he's very good to me. I met him outside going on my first ride and he told me to come up and ride up here, and I'm up here nearly every second morning, and he's been very good to me. He's given me loads of rides and very grateful.
And jet streaming in Galway was very good to you?
Yeah, it was lovely to get a winner in Galway. She's a lovely little filly and she's only improving as she's going along, so she's on to look forward.
You've had 3 rides on her and 2 winners, so she's been good to you?
Yeah, very good.
And Zeftin, the last day in the curd, and he was very good as well.
Zeftin, yeah, he's one of the yard favourites. He loves the curd. I must have won the Apprentice Derby on him, and won the 2 weeks later in the curd again. He's a good, genuine horse, loves the curd, and I'm sure there's another one in him.
Must have been great winning the Apprentice Derby up in the curd.
Yeah, it was great. Same weekend as the Derby. Great to get a winner in the curd at that big stage, so it was.
And it was to step up back up to 2 mile from the last day suiting him as well then?
To 2 mile, yeah. He's going on the ground in fairness. He's a good, hardy, strong horse, and he's going on his trip in fairness.
And everybody, anyone who know who you are will know your background in horses, so you're in horses all your life. And
yeah, I was right into it. Father, Dusty Sheehy, he had a good few jump horses back in the time, Rack Arbonne, so there's no escape from it.
You have a great background as well with pony racing then as well.
Yeah, got great experience with pony racing. I rode just over nearly 170 winners. I rode for great lads such as Jerry Daly and Batsy Maher, and they were very good to me, and it was a great experience coming up, stepping up onto the track.
And what are the plans for the rest of the season ahead? Just try and get as many rides as you can?
Yeah, keep going the way I am. Try and bang in as many winners and keep going from there.
You're only 4 winners to go until you lose your claim then as well. So
4 winners, yeah. So look, we'll keep kicking out and see how things go.
And Jetstream will be out a couple more times this season, so hopefully she'll be able to give you another winner.
She'll probably win a few in the back end of the season with the soft ground, and she'll be stepping up and trip again, so she'll want to look forward.
Adrian, just coming back here now from first lot. Done a little bit on the sand they did. Horses are running well though. Plenty of winners since I seen it last time.
Yeah, thank God. We had a nice winner in Galway, and a nice filly got a bit of black type on her, so she's back in a listed race now on Wednesday in Killarney, so the ground I'm hoping should suit her down there again. We've a couple of nice runners this weekend as well. G-Force runs today, the ground for the first time this year he'll be getting his ground to suit.
Yeah.
I think this step up to 7 should suit him, so hopefully
he's a bit older, that'll help him.
Yeah, and hopefully he can make a good account of himself. He was in good nick in Ascot and the run wasn't that bad, but I think just the fact that he'd ran on that real quick ground in Ascot, the fact that he'd ran on it, he wasn't going to prepare to run on it the second time as nettle his last run, you know, so yeah. hopefully that's his reasons for them runs. And
tomorrow then, the last time I was up with you, I seen a horse that you're very fond of, London Icon, and he runs tomorrow.
Yeah, he runs tomorrow. He'd been working away and we've been tipping away with him, but he'd done a real nice piece on Tuesday morning, which looked good to the eye, so and he seems to be real sharp out of the gates. He seems to be ready to go. So hopefully he'll give a good account of himself tomorrow, and he'll be there or thereabouts. It looks a serious race on paper. There's serious pedigrees there. That alone, Aidan O'Brien, but Johnny Morta has a half brother there to lethal force. And
you never get an easy maiden up in the car anyway, so.
No. But look at it, we're hoping our lad is sharp enough and knows his job well enough, and hopefully he can be there about to bend.
And lovely horse you have that we spoke about the last day, Papa Store. He's on this lot here. You'll be hoping to run him soon. He's a lovely horse.
Yeah, he's a cracking horse. When he'll run now is I don't know, but he will run. He'll run within the next 4 or 5 weeks, hopefully. But there's a nice bunch of 2-year-olds there now. There's a lovely thin scale Fior horse there that's going to be a cracking. If he's not going to be a nice horse at the back end of this year, he's definitely going to be one next year as a 3-year-old.
Okay.
Lovely Dark Angel horse there, and a big laid back Most Improved horse. Young Danny is on there. He's a great constitution for it, because he's so relaxed and loves his work and minds his own business, eats up and does everything right. So there should be a nice race in him. And a lovely Born to See filly who's not named yet.
She's a fine mover, isn't she?
Lovely mover, covers a good bit of ground. Whether she'll run or not, she probably will run this year. But the Born to See's seem to be improving with age and time. So if she's up to running, we'll run her. If she'll tell us if she's not. So if she's not, there's no panic. She's a nice filly for the future.
When I was up, which is the last time, you spoke about jet streaming, and you told me she's ready to run. When she runs, she'll win. And you were right. She won at Leopardstown, and since then, obviously won in Galway.
Yeah, won really well in Leopardstown. I was probably in between Leopardstown and the Curra run. I was probably a little bit kind to her, and we always had Galway, that race in Galway in mind. So the conditions seem to suit her, even though she wants an ease in it. I don't think she wants real heavy ground. I don't think she has the scope or the limbs to be pulling herself out of that real heavy ground. She ran in Tipperary one day, Pat Smullen rode her, and I don't think she handled it that well, but she definitely loves an ease in the ground. So hopefully we'll have her for the mile and a quarter handicap Champions weekend up to Curra. So and then hopefully we'll see how that goes, and maybe we might go to France with her at the end of October, around November time, for a bit of black type, hopefully.
Going back to the Galway race when she won, it looked like coming down the hill that she wasn't going to win, but the further she was going, the better she was, and she was going away from them then towards the end. She was very good.
Yeah, and it suited in that ground. They went nice and quick in that ground, which suited her, and Danny was able to slot in down the railings and take her time, and a nice opening came for him. So he never had to check or never had to break his stride. That it opened up in front of him, so he was able to build his momentum from the time he got stuck into her, and she had all the momentum, and she just rolled down over the top of him and got there late. And the day it looked like she only got up a head or probably from the camera angle, but she actually won a half a length, so she won.
And the further she was going to go, the further she was going to go away from
him. Yeah. She's probably a mile and a quarter this year now, and probably definitely step her up to a mile and a half next year.
Okay. And talking about Danny, great rider, great value for the £7 claim.
Yeah, well, he's great value for a seven at the moment, and with these lads, I think words like great with these young fellas, with all of us really, great is a big word, but he's definitely a very good rider. He's a good fella to add to it. Doesn't say much what he says, he doesn't say anything just for the sake of it, you know what I mean?
Yep.
So what he says means something, and all the owners seem to like him. He gets a tune out of him, another couple of seasons time he could be a serious prospect.
And credit to yourself, you know, with like trainers like yourself working so hard, and you need horses to run well. It's not easy to put the young lads up on them, but you've been very good to him, how you came about him and told him to come up to ride out, and he's got his rewards for that, but you're being rewarded too by using him.
Yeah. But the when you get seven off these middling horses, or especially horses when they're stepping up into handicaps, and they need all the help they can get, a valuable seven is vital. You know, it's a big thing. So. Look, we're glad to have him, and hopefully we can keep going.
That's good. Surely must be another trip to England coming up soon. You always do well when you bring your horses over.
Yeah, I have a filly in York on Thursday. We probably won't go with her in the filly's listed race over there. We probably won't go. She got a little break, so we'll probably go to Clarny with her instead. So look, and probably air Gold Cup meeting is beyond the agenda next, and we'll surely have a few, we have plenty for the lesser meetings, so there'll be trips coming up. There's nothing in the pipelines. Oh, sorry, I do actually, a Fast Last next Friday. I've three entered over there, so if the Dale wants soft ground, so if the ground is soft over there,
we'll go there.
Yeah, so when everyone else is in York, I'll be in Fast Last.
It's all about the winners though, isn't it?
Yeah, fucking sure, I go anywhere for them.
You're busy today, Danny. Five rides, two in the Curragh, three in Tramore.
Yeah, two rides in the Curragh. I ride G-force for Adrian. Luckily now the rain came, likes a bit of juice in the ground, and he should go well. I have one for Philip Burns as well. Ran all right my first time sitting up on it. And then I'm heading down to Tramore for three rides there, so first time riding there, so busy enough today. Now.
Good to be busy.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, listen, good meeting you, and best luck for the rest of the season. Thanks. And I'm sure we'll see you keep riding plenty of winners.
Cheers, thanks David.